Okay, hello everyone, and welcome back to Dead Island. And today we'll be continuing our game. We're in the middle of a couple of side quests right now. We are doing well. We've just finished Cold Blood or In Cold Blood, which is to kill Mugambi's undead family, and we're going to be going on to do Heroes and Villains for Vang Chi, which is over at the waterfront district, which is not too far from where we are now, luckily. So hopefully we'll be able to round that up and head back to the church to finish three side quests, actually, because we picked up Last Chance, or Last Will rather, from Carrot Bargain, who, by the way, will not be there if we ever go back to that spot. But yeah, once we go through here though, we're going to have an infected surprise, so not looking forward to it, but it's the only way to get out of the house. So, yeah. Luckily, though, we are healed up. Got our health back. We're at max health, I should say. And, yep, there's an infected. There's an infected over there, probably. And there's an infected around the corner, which is always fun. Dealt with him. That zombie there isn't doing anything, which is fine by me. And if we go around here, the infected will spot us via line of sight. Yeah, there he is. And here he comes. Lovely. Okay, at least we dealt with it. That walker still hasn't seen us. That's fine. Spiteful pistol. Yoink. Also, take this. Yoink. Which pistol does the most damage? 218, 180, 148, 218. Okay, so these two are exactly the same. This one sells for slightly less, so we're going to equip that. And we're going to unequip this one. No, sorry, we're going to unequip this one. There you go. And then this one sells for 355, so we're going to keep that one for now. Lovely, okay. Was that infected I just heard? Oh, it was. Goody. Hello, sir. Sir, hello? Hello? I don't want you running up to me at some other time. Come on. Your pathfinding will figure out eventually how to get to me. Come on, you've almost got it. You've almost got it. I'm gonna have to come over here to you, aren't I? Jesus Christ. Right, okay. Wastewater plant, we're not going there yet. That's for the main quest. Instead, we're going to go this way. Way down here, we're just going to hop up here. Yeah, we got nothing for right now. Which is good, no zombies. This is a gun shop. However, you can't get in here yet. You get into here during a side quest. Hello. Yeah, you get into here in a side quest. Which you only get during Act 3 when you come back to Moresby. So, yeah, that's interesting. So, yeah, Suicider, he is on fire. That he's no longer on fire. There you go, he's dead. Wait, easy peasy. So the wastewater plant is literally right there. Is there a ram? There is no ram, as we didn't hear him screaming. Which is good. Ow. Okay, we're lucky that didn't do much damage from his throw. Get out of here. There you go. Nice. Okay. And here is the waterfront district, specifically the docks area of the waterfront district. And Amber is held in
Stop!
there.
When you close in, we'll shoot.
There's a punk,
No one gets through.
Yeah.
We give you nothing. No food, nothing. Get the fuck out of here.
No. I will be here if I want. It's my right as a Bannoy tourist to go where I please. We're just going to do that. We are going to just quickly repair our weapons. So the hammer, repair that. Yeah, the sledgehammer. Lovely. Okay, and now we're going to equip the pistol. Actually, no, we're going to keep the flange space equipped just for now because we're going to go up here quick. This is, again, a place that you come to during Act 3, where you have to come through here. There's a zombie hiding. Zombie hiding around the corner, but yeah, I just missed my kick. Yeah, so this is a place you come to during Act 3. We can get into this container and retrieve a quest item, but for right now, we can't access it. Obviously, we're not in Act 3. So, just quickly though, were there any healing items? No. Are there any up here? Don't believe so. There's none there. Oh no, there were healing items, that's right. Two extra snacks. Not bad. Fun fact about the extra snacks, they all have Deimos printed on them, which is a different moon of Mars, I think it is. So yeah, it's a play on the Mars bar. But yeah, these are punks here. As you can see, they're not very nice. This guy's lined up nicely for a headshot. There you go, just take you out. You can't do this stealthily. For example, if I just crouch, there you go. And all of a sudden more of them have spawned. Shoot you. Yeah, we're just looking out for any sort of melee punks because they're just not very nice. We can get through here, yes, that's right. What I'm going to do quick is actually activate the quest. Here are some villains, there you go, then we'll see where the punks are. Fire the red skulls. So there you go, oh, there's a ram outside. Hello. Where's the punk? There's the punk. Come on, there you go. Yep, good, reload. Yoink, and yoink your pistol. Any melee punks want to come out? Not for right now, that's fine. Oh, I should have sort of shot the melee punk in the head already. Fine. Ooh, 332. 201, and then 337, so we'll just drop both of these actually, because we got pistols to pick up. So drop that, and we'll drop this as well. And yoink. And yeah, there's nothing to collect, which is fine and dandy. Just head over here instead, and ow. Ooh, okay, that was close. Ooh, okay, that's even closer. There, ladies and gentlemen, is our first death of the thief. I'm concerned where we're going to be respawned. We're respawned out here. There's a ram outside somewhere. But yeah, that's the first death of the playthrough, and I'm not too surprised, to be fair, that the death is due to a melee punk. Because these guys really do suck to fight, I'm going to be honest. Melee punks are really not fun. But yeah, it's unfortunate that we died. Every time you die in Dead Island, you lose some cash. You lose a percentage of your cash. Xian Mei has got a skill that will decrease the amount of money you lose upon death. But we're Sam B, so of course we don't have that. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get up here. And we're on a vantage point so that we can see them all. Or at least that's the plan. Oh, there you go, he's dead. Where's another punk? There's one. Can I spot? Can I get you from here? Oh no, he's moved. They leveled up. If only we'd had that whilst we were fighting the melee punks, then I might not have died, but... Come on. There you go. Still, we leveled up. Which means I'm going to take Blunt Weapon Expert. There you go, that's going to give me some more damage. And I can use the Stomp ability now, which is a fun ability. Where's Pucks? There's one over here. There he is. Got him. Where's the other one? Oh, there he is. Yep, back on. Now we can drop down. Ouch. And now we can loot for some nice money. 411 for that pistol. 374. Yum. 318. Ugh, not very good cash wise there. Yoink. 297, that's even worse. 271. Not really worth it. Because what are my current pistols at? 332, 294, 236, 359, 355, 414, yeah. So where are those other 200-300-ish monies? There's one, yoink. And there's the other one, yoink. Right. Nope. There you go. I think one of these guys has an auto rifle, but I could be wrong. Where is he? There he is. Okay. Well, that got both of them. Personal ID, yoink. 258, yeah, that's worth it. And it's like to stop at 337. Okay, fine. Tyrant Cudgel, yeah, that's not worth it. And now Amber. Yeah, so there she is, she's being held hostage. We just need to go bang, lovely. Take this pistol ammo. And there she is, hello. And we get the lightning rod. Hooray! Right. Very good. Now we just need to make it all the way back home. And to do that, I think we're just going to take the car and drive. Actually, it'll be quicker just to go to Nick's. I'll be honest. So that's what we'll do. It means we'll have to fight the thug, but... not the thug. The ram. But that's fine. That is absolutely fine and dandy. We can probably do that nice and easy. Yeah, I am a bit sad by the death that we took, though. Yeah, melee punks. That's just how they are. They do ungodly amounts of damage for what they are. But now that this area is cleared of punks, it means that every time from now on that we ever come back here, there will be zombies occupying this area instead. Punks were keeping them from being around this area, but now that we've gone and cleared them out, zombies will inhabit the area instead. So out front here and inside there, and indeed in the warehouse area, there's just going to be zombies. So yeah, we got to watch out for that now. Are you just going to keep walking? No, you're not. The hell was that charge? That wasn't even going to hit me even if I didn't dodge out the way. Are you stuck? No, you're not. Ow, yeah, you're very much not stuck. I dodged that. What are these charges, my guy? You got killed by a ram ability. Okay. Stop. That's him dealt with, at least, I suppose. At least by coming down here, I'll be able to show you where the next chance on the wall is. Actually, now that I'm here, I can equip these things. So the Morning Star. Yoink. There it is. Lovely, lovely wooden Morning Star. And there we go. That blunt damage up is really useful. Zombies, are you interested or not? Doesn't look like they are, which is fine. I'll just jump onto the ambulance. There you go. Lovely. Sledgehammer. Sledgehammer time. Oh, come on. You really do walk slow, don't you? Smack. An infected is normally over there, so we've got to watch out for that. Also, during the second head of Cerberus, a thug will spawn here, so that's something to look forward to in a later episode. Come on, madam. There you go. Dealt with her. Yeah, that's a group of zombies I don't particularly want to deal with. However, by being here, we do have access to the next poster location for Howard. So, there you go. Howard Craigson, your poster is going up. There you go, lovely. And then the next poster location is back over there somewhere, so... Oh, there's a thug here already! Hello! Hello, friend. And he's died from the bleed damage. Lovely. Okay. Yeah, another one of those megaphone areas for the Head of Cerberus quest. Just need to quickly deal with this woman. And these two. Very good. You died as well. Excellent. Lovely. Love it when a plan comes together like that. Just quickly going to head onto this van. Oh, not fall off the edge. And we can rinse and repeat this as much as we want. So, yeah, these guys are just going to easy peasy die. And you are dead as well. Is there an infected over there? That's the real question. I hope not, but I'm sure we'll soon find out. We loot the bodies and take the medkit. Eastern Waterfront District, we're going to head over here. And actually what we're going to do is we're going to head over here as well. Because if we head under here... There you go. We head under here, there's a metal chest. So, yeah. Fun fact, metal chest. Also fun fact, infected. There was an infected over there. Peekaboo. Oh, he didn't die. Come on. Yeah, okay, that means we need to get rid of this thing now. At some point. We're going to try and parkour over here. There we go. And we're going to go see Nick. Nick at the abandoned house. And the only reason we're doing this is so we can fast travel. And I'm going to fast travel first to the warehouse to check on Florencio and see if he has got anything interesting for me, and then we're going to just head to the church and finish off the side quests. So, warehouse. Let's not take forever, right? Loading a City of Moresby, come on. There you go. Right, Florencio, good day. You have a diabolical mace. Now that's something I'm interested in. First of all, though, I have a whole bunch of pistols. I probably should have checked their damages first, but still, 221, let's just have a check. 220, 233. There's some 233s, these 414s, but you know what? Doesn't particularly matter. I'm just going to buy the mace. Thanks very much, Florencio.
Let's open this up.
Oh, and a nice crowbar as well. Oh, Florencio, you should have. That's excellent, excellent news. We've got a lot of good weapons. So, yeah, my top gear top tip is try to only prioritize rare and very rare upwards weapons. So only blue, purple, or orange weapons, because they'll last for a lot longer than common or uncommon, aka white or green weapons. And yeah, when you do end up needing to sell them, they'll sell for a decent amount. So only ever try to buy those weapons. But yeah, there you go. We'll talk to Magumbe.
May God have mercy on their souls.
And we get a defective heavy pistol. But it's fine because that does more damage than our regular pistol currently. So, and it's also, it does more damage, it's less accurate, and has a slower rate of fire. But it's cheaper. And yeah, deals more damage, so I'm going to sell the pistol for higher damage. Now we need to go upstairs for Owain. There he is. Oh no, it's Raymond! Ah, Owain gives a different one. Also, Banoi Heraldex there. But yeah, we got to talk to Raymond. Or Raymond, rather. There you go, there's that. So we get some cash from them. And one last thing that I will do, actually, just before the end of the episode. I'm actually going to quickly head to the lighthouse in the resort. And the reason I'm doing this is so that we can check on Xavier and see if he is currently selling a heavy Morning Star. Because I think we have the cash to buy it now.
Okay, here to take
soap. Me. Nothing. Well, don't be sneaking up. Oh no, he didn't do that. He's not selling anything. I came here for you. And you give me nothing. Still, at least we're in a nice place here to end it off. So yeah, we did some extra things here. We do have some resort-based quests, which I'll do probably later on when we come back here during Act 2, before we head to the jungle. I'll come back here and finish off those things. So really what we have to do left in Moresby is Garrett Grant's quests, really, which we can do Blood Ties during first head of Cerberus, and then we've got the other heads of Cerberus to do, and then that'll be that. And then we can go on and do the rest of the main quest. So that's going to be the plan. I'm going to actually end it off here as the lovely lighthouse. So yeah, we made decent progress. We've got some decent weapons under our belt, as you can see. I just equipped the heavy pistol. Yoink. And yeah, we've got some decent weapons now. We have a decent amount of cash. We have got the lightning mod, which actually, I might actually go and mod some weapons quick, since we're here with the workbench. Oh, and I can collect the wire and duct tape from inside of the lighthouse. There you go, inside of here. So we've got the $40 there, well, 40 cash, duct tape, wire, and then upgrade, create lightning mod. Yes, here we go, look at all those things we could use on the lightning mod. Now the hammer is a bit of a waste, due to how low level it is. Sure, it will give us a little bit of extra damage and the electricity bonus, but yeah, it's not a high enough level now, really. I should probably give that to Jin. So instead, what we want to use it on is, I think, the mace. I'm not going to use it on the crowbar yet, but I think definitely the mace and the wrench to do with it. So use it on the wrench. Sledgehammer is debatable whether I use it on that. That mace, yes, lightning mace, how much does it cost? It costs 400 for us to do it. Oh yeah, meat bait as well, we can use these. Take some of these, because meat bait is great. The hell did I, oh, I used the weighted mod on them. I didn't mean to do that. We only have the weighted mod on it. I might change that. I might change that in the save file. Just because the weighted mod is a terrible, terrible mod. Morning Star? Possibly. I'll have a think before next episode. Yeah, I think what we've done is good. Having these two things as lightning. How much to upgrade? Ooh, expensive. I will upgrade them to the first two levels. And then, yeah, I will, I think, go into the save file and just change the sledgehammer off of the weighted mod, because it's a terrible mod to have, I'm going to be honest, compared to what we could have on it. Because the weighted mod only increases the critical damage. It really doesn't do anything else for us. So, yeah, I might just go and change that. But for now, we've got some decent things now. We have some actual modded weapons. And yeah, that's just something we'd like to have. I'll sell this thing probably now that we have some decent stuff. And yeah, this is how we're looking. We're looking pretty good. Here's our lightning wrench. Very nice. So yeah, let's get out of here. I'll thank you all for watching, and goodbye.